Evander Holyfield's Real Deal Boxing was my absolute favorite boxing game of all time. That is until, very recently, I started playing Boxing Legends of the Ring. And I think this game has overtaken that mantle of my favorite boxing game of all time. Now, unlike Evander Holyfield's Real Deal Boxing that only had one real boxer, this game has a ton of really great boxers. It doesn't have the cliche boxers. It doesn't have the Foremans and Alis, who are, honestly, I mean, they're great, but overrated. Take Ali for a second, okay? Muhammad Ali. You know how everyone is saying he's the greatest? You know where that started, the epicenter of that? Himself. He was walking around saying he's the greatest. Then a few sports journalists started saying, you know what? He's the greatest. The fact is, Ali was very good when he was younger, but his career kind of tampered off. When he turned about 29, he kind of lost some of his skill and luster, and he never really got much of it back. By the end of his career, Ali wasn't very good, honestly. And he wasn't like 49 by the end of his career, he was still in his 30s. And for a heavyweight, that's nothing. Like, George Foreman won the title well into his 40s. The Klitschko brothers have been dominating boxing for a decade, and they're both in the age range of late 30s to early 40s. For a heavyweight, being in your 30s and even 40s isn't that huge of a deal, simply because the majority of the stuff you lose with age is speed, and heavyweights don't rely on speed as much as other weight classes. I would say pound for pound, heavyweights rely way more on power and stamina and timing than speed. Of course, all boxers need speed, it's an essential, but I'd say for the heavyweights, it's the third most essential thing. So who do I think is the greatest boxer of all time? Well, to say that, I would need to go before 2004-ish, because the careers of a lot of great boxers right now aren't over. But I think, pound for pound, Rocky Marciano has to be, at least, if not the greatest boxer of all time, the greatest heavyweight of all time. The guy went undefeated, and he was a small heavyweight. The guy was only 5'10". His reach was crap. His reach was 67 inches. I mean, for a heavyweight, that's nothing. I mean, this is a guy who could have been fighting at light heavyweight or middleweight, but he chose to fight at heavyweight. And he completely dominated. Rocky Marciano is the only heavyweight champion to never be defeated. And I guess you could say, well, Ali faced harder competition. BS, Ali faced harder competition. Rocky Marciano fought people from the toughest generation in America's history, the World War II generation. I mean, that's a generation of people tough as nails. There's no way people from the 60s, their children were tougher. There's no way in hell. But let's get off this diatribe a little bit and let's talk about why this is my favorite boxing game of all time. I love a game where you have to use strategy, and a game where you think. Also, when it comes to fighting games, I love them to be as realistic as possible. Simply put, that's why Punch-Out isn't my favorite boxing game of all time. Of course, it's a classic, it's an amazing game, but it simply wasn't a realistic boxing game, and I need my fighting games to be as realistic as possible. This game uses pure strategy. You use the A button to punch with your left hand, you use the C button to punch with your right hand. You can change the different punches by using the A and C buttons with the directional pad. So say if you hold the down button and the A button, you're going to do an uppercut. The B button lets you clinch to maybe gain energy or save yourself from a beatdown, but also you can bob and weave with the B button, which is pretty useless in this game. The reason for this being is the best strategy when defending yourself is to simply defend yourself. You press up to block high attacks, you press down to block low attacks. It's just that simple. And when you're blocking, the enemy is not hurting you at all. I mean, literally, your opponent is hurting himself more than he's hurting you when he's punching you as you block. How's he hurting himself? Well, he's hurting himself in terms of his stamina going down. The boxing gloves near the portraits of the characters are your stamina. As your stamina goes down, you become slower and weaker, and when your stamina is out, that's when it's time for your opponent to attack. And when you have no stamina, you can imagine how badly you get your ass kicked. But still, you can block when you have no stamina. So even if your stamina runs out, if you're very good at seeing what part of your body your opponent is punching, you probably won't even be in trouble when your stamina is completely out. The portrait themselves tell you how badly you're getting hurt and how badly your opponent is getting hurt. You also have a special move which you choose yourself. Like when you're creating your career mode character, you choose which special move you will be using in this game. And the special move is just like any other move, but you can only use it when you have a tiny little boxing gloves above the big boxing glove. You generally start every fight with one special move you can use, and then every knockdown you score, you get another special move. And you can execute the special moves by pressing A and C together. As you can imagine, this is very cumbersome. You have to take your hand off the directional buttons and actually move to the right, and then you can't be moving, so you have to time it just right. Also, the animation with the special is being executed, it takes much longer than an average move, and when your opponents are really fast and hit really hard, as they do all throughout the game, but especially in the later fights, the special moves really need to be timed well. I mean, they do great damage, but if you don't time it well, your opponent would just punch you like 5 times before you can even execute the move. And all the people you fight in this game are just hardcore. It's really, really hard to score a TKO or a knockout in this game. And this is because most opponents need you to knock them down 3 times in a round to actually win by a TKO or a knockout. That is to say, if you knock down an opponent twice in every round for 10 rounds straight, he will probably continue to fight, and he's going to be as strong as ever. These are like the elite of the elite. Of course, this is unrealistic. There is no such thing in real boxing. I mean, if you knock someone down twice in a round for 11 rounds, even if the opposing corner doesn't throw in the towel, the referee would have to stop that fight because that would be a massacre. The reason they gave the fighters this unbelievable hard in this game is to make each fight last as long as possible. And most of the fights you have are epic. They will go the distance. Most of the fights I have had in this game have gone over 20 minutes. That's each fight being about 8 to 12 rounds, with each round being about 3 minutes. Yeah, it's all about endurance in this game. It's just like a real heavyweight title bout. My one and only gripe with the game would be that it can get pretty easy, simply because all your opponents have a certain strategy and they continue using that same strategy throughout the fight for 12 rounds. And after about the third or fourth round, you more or less get their strategy down. You see that this one guy is punching you 3 times in the head, and then he goes for a really powerful body punch, and then he kind of steps away. And you can memorize your opponent's technique, so even if you lose the first 3 rounds, you can pretty much predict how your opponent is gonna fight for the next 7 rounds. So the fights never really become hard if you really pay attention to what your opponent is doing and you actually study your opponent, which is great. I mean, I love the fact that your brain and your intelligence is the strongest tool in this game, not your ability to press a button really fast. And this same strategy goes for blocking as well. When you can get your opponent's strategy down, you will barely ever get hit because you know exactly how many punches your opponent is going to throw and what kind of punches they are. So you'll just stand there and block, have your opponent tire himself out, throwing punches as you just casually stand there and barely take any damage. And when he's tired, you counter him with your own combinations. I would have liked to see the opponents in this game kind of change their strategies up a bit, like maybe change their strategy in every round or change their strategy when they're losing, but they don't. But I guess that's kind of asking too much for a game from the old generation of consoles. I mean, even Fight Night opponents don't change their strategy, even on the hardest difficulty. In the career mode, you make your character, you put a bunch of points into your favorite types of punches, and you put a bunch of points into what kind of attributes you want to have be the strongest. And after every fight, you gain a few points to put into your attributes. So by the time you become the number one heavyweight in the world and people are challenging you for the title, you're probably going to be completely maxed out in terms of your attributes. The combat in this game is nothing but fun, simply because all the opponents have different strengths and weaknesses, all the opponents use different strategies, and all the opponents are really fun to fight because all the fights last long, and you feel like you actually accomplished something when you beat an opponent. This game is both for the Super Nintendo and the Sega Genesis, but I only got to play the Genesis version. This is footage from my gameplay of the Genesis version. I do plan on trying out the Super Nintendo version. I'm sure it's more or less the same, but since the Nintendo just has more buttons, I bet I probably wouldn't need to press A and C to execute the special, so it's probably going to be a little easier to fight, if anything. Boxing Legends of the Ring is my new favorite boxing game of all time, and it gets an official Stan Birdman rating of a 9.5 out of 10. This game's only real bad attribute is the fact that it gets too easy, but it only gets too easy once you get too good, and the only reason you get too good is because you can't put the game down. Thanks for watching. Goodbye, my friends.